गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. नाउ अगेन वी विल स्टडी द सेम चैप्टर 3 लॉज ऑफ मोशन, बट द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज न्यूटन्स सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. न्यूटन्स सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन, वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज लीनियर मोमेंटम, और सिंपली यू कैन से मोमेंटम. नाउ लिसन माई एक्सप्लेनेशन. इफ टू बॉडीज ऑफ डिफरेंट masses are moving with the same velocity and they are brought to rest in same time, the force needed to stop the heavier body is more than that for the lighter body. Similarly, if you can say if two bodies of the same mass are moving with different velocities, then to stop them in the same time, the force needed for the faster moving body is more than for the slower moving body. So what you we can say that the force needed to stop a moving body in a definite time depends on the mass and the velocity. Or you can say what is momentum or linear momentum of a body? It is the product of its mass and velocity. Its symbol is small p. Formula is p is equal to mass into velocity. M is the mass, v is the velocity. It is a vector quantity. SI unit is, see children, unit you can learn, you can take out from here only. Mass is kilogram and velocity is meter per second. CGS unit is gram centimeter per second. So SI unit is kg meter per second and CGS unit is gram centimeter per second. Next is the change in momentum. Now change in momentum, you see, it is given by this formula, delta p is equal to m delta v, where this sign represents delta. Here the change in product, this change in product m into v can be either due to the change in the mass or due to the change in the velocity or due to change in both the mass and the velocity. So we can give, so we can say rate of change of momentum is equal to change in momentum upon time, or you can say m v minus u upon time. And now we know that v minus u, we know acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time, that is v minus u. Here a is equal to v minus u upon t. So you can give this formula, rate of change of momentum is equal to m into a. And this is Newton's expression of second law of motion. Now here Newton concluded that the acceleration, here A is the acceleration produced in a body of given mass, is directly proportional to the force applied on it. This A is directly proportional to the force if mass remains constant. Second conclusion, the force needed to produce a given acceleration in a body is directly proportional to the mass of the body. Here F is directly proportional to the mass if acceleration remains the same. Now when you combine both these equations, you will get F is equal to M into A, where K is a constant. So F is equal to M into A. This is the mathematical expression of Newton's second law of motion. Now what, how you will define Newton's second law of motion? The rate of change of momentum of a body is directly proportional to the applied force and takes place in the direction in which the force acts. This is called Newton's second law of motion. Here we are talking about force. So what is the unit of force? Force unit is Newton, and CGS unit of force is dyne. What is the relation? 1 Newton is equal to 10 ki power 5. Now here, what is 1 Newton and what is 1 dyne? 1 Newton is the force which when acts on a body of a mass 1 kg produces an acceleration of 1 meter per second square. Why I am saying 1 meter per second square? Because A, acceleration unit is meter per second square. Relation, this is the relation. And what is 1 dyne? It is the force which when acts on a body of mass 1 gram. Here you will say gram, and acceleration is 1 centimeter per second square, because centimeter is the CGS unit and dyne is the CGS unit of Newton. So children, Now I have given the assignment to you. First exercise 3A, these questions I have given. First question, explain giving two example, contact forces, non-contact forces. Third question, give one example of each case. Then children, this 8th question, give an example of each case of the following cases when a force stops a moving body, change the size of the body, changes the shape of the body. Now children, coming to exercise 3B. 3B, question number 6, 8, 9, 11, 13, 18, 19, 20 and 21, this all you have to give. Now coming to exercise 3C. Exercise 3C. Question number 5. First question number 1, 2, 6, 7, 9, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. These questions, children, you have to do it in your physics register and maintain your physics register